So, Mikey, do you have a good experience at the expo? Do you talk to any of the other fighters, like Ward?
I didn't ask you to speak to anybody except when I went to see Marquez real quick, take a picture, you know, just hello. Ward, before he left,
what did he say?
Came to the booth because he's with Fight Label. Yeah. Said hello. Jesse said hi. Abner said hi, of course. But I didn't get a chance to actually, like, go, you know. It's hard to really try to do that.
No, you're there for fans.
All the fans are there. And I mean, I would like to go see Barrera also. You know, another of my favorites. Barrera, you know, one of my favorites. But
very nice guy, too. Very
too many people, you know, you can't really make it.
And honestly, that's one of the reasons I didn't want to do too many interviews there. Because the fans, these are new fans that never get to see you and meet you. And this is their one opportunity.
They're there to, you know, so, waiting in line for 2 hours or so.
Exactly.
Just for an opportunity to take a picture, photo and an autograph. So it's you really have to give them that moment for them.
But I noticed you didn't charge them really for the pictures or the autographs. No. Other fighters charge them up to $50 an autograph. No, I know. I'm not saying any names. One of the fighters made.
Maybe that's why the byline was bigger too.
Could be. Yeah, that makes sense.
In music too. Like when I do shows, like other artists, they charge for taking pictures. I'm like, I can't charge. I don't feel right in my conscience to charge someone for a picture.
You're making money already.
Yeah, so.
Maybe. And they love you.
Maybe if I was broke, I would. I guess. But in my life, I've never charged. I've never sold a poster. They sell posters. I've never done that.
The way I kind of can see or find a way to actually
monetize it,
if the store or whoever promoting the event.
Whoa, you okay?
Whoever's promoting the event, you know, is already gonna pay you up front. Hey, we're gonna pay you, you know, this amount of money for two hours of your time.
Yeah, of course.
And then you obviously will give everything, you know, autographs, pictures, whatever.
But you always stay 5-6 hours.
I do longer.
But it don't make it look like.
Like you're the one charged, because it's someone else, you know, some store.
It's like when Nick and Nate do their signings.
Can you imagine that? Can you imagine you just charge, hey, take a picture. Yeah, here, give me $20. I'll take a picture with you. I can never find anybody to do that. Yeah.
But some fighters do that, and, you know, maybe they don't have a choice, or maybe that's the only way to get them to show up. Like when Nick and Nate do appearances, they don't charge, the store may charge people, but they get their.
They got paid up front.
Yeah.
I mean, now that's business. That's different. That's just the business that you're doing with the store.
Okay, if you had to walk Mikey Garcia out with a song, what song do you go with? Eye of the Tiger? What was their name? The band's name? What's the band's name? What's the band's name?
Survivor.
Survivor.
That's just my ultimate pump-up song. That was just top of the head, that ultimate pump-up song. I myself didn't do pump-up music. I did, like, stuff for the ladies. Making babies and shit, you know, after the fight.
Making babies.
Man, ladies and making babies, man, that's what I do. That rhymed, I like that.
One of his videos, Mikey?
Them shoes come like that?
Yeah.
What are those?
Dunks.
One of his videos has like 180 million views. Yeah. Just one. It's crazy.
Yeah, I mean, I'm not into views. I mean, you're more into views than I am, but yeah.
Just interesting. Cool.
I like views.
Bash, you never tried to do any acting? Movies?
I was in a movie called Philly Brown with Edward James Olmos, Lou Diamond Phillips, and Gina Rodriguez, who's like big time right now, Gina Rodriguez. So yeah, that was my first and only movie because I can't act. But they kept telling me, want you in this movie. So if you watch Philly Brown, I'm Caesar, the loan shark, and I just acted myself. I had no script. They just told me what the whole thing was about. And
so you played yourself?
I talked my, like, yeah, because they tried to give me a script. I was like, I don't talk like this, bro. Like, it was too square, you know what I mean? They want me to talk like real funny.
Plain,
Mike, and I was like, no, I can't talk like that.
They did a movie about Kobe Bryant. It was called Who Shot Mamba? But in the movie, it's a pet snake that's a doll, like, you know, made like a doll on strings. Yeah. So the same situation. I was playing a reporter, and they gave me lines, and I kept talking like a robot, like I'm reading. Because it's not. I said, let me be myself. And the director said, no, you have to sit to the script. They ended up putting in the movie, and I sound like a robot.
I've gotten scripts my whole career, like big fat scripts.
Yeah.
But I don't sit there and read the whole script. And I know I can't act. I'm not a good liar. I can't act, bro. That's just me. I'm just who I am.
Fernando Vargas was in one movie, and he did pretty good.
Yeah, he was in the
Alpha Dog.
Yeah.
That was a good movie.
And he got to play himself, kind of like, you know, just a.
Yeah, getting in a fight.
Yeah, getting into some shit. Yeah.
He's always.
But I can't just cry all of a sudden. Okay, I want you to cry. You know what I'm saying? Like, okay, or I can't do all that shit. Some people are good at that shit.